Good evening and welcome. Can everyone hear? Great. My name is Bill Music and I have the pleasure of serving as the CEO of Hospice East Bay and also as a member of the Pleasant Hill Commission on Aging. And it's my pleasure to welcome you tonight. Hospice East Bay was founded in 1977 and is the only not-for-profit hospice located in Contra Costa County. We're committed to providing high quality, compassionate care to all those needing our services, regardless of the ability to pay. Our service area includes not only Contra Costa County, but parts of Alameda and Solano counties as well. We provide hospice services to approximately 1,500 patients and families each year. And our community-based palliative care program provides an added layer of support for those with chronic illnesses in advance of hospice care. Thanks to donors like you, through events like this Tree of Lights tonight, Hospice East Bay offers a wide array of services that most hospices can't provide. Some of those programs include a music therapy program, where music is a therapeutic tool, reduces pain and anxiety, and brings joy to patients and families during a very complex and difficult time. Our veteran-centered care program helps veterans with and their families with the unique needs associated with military service, including assistance in accessing the support and benefits they've earned through their service to our country. Our grief support services are offered both in person and virtually, and we're proud that these services are available to anyone in our community, not only those who've been on service with Hospice East Bay. Tonight, we gather to honor and remember our departed loved ones and to honor special people in our lives. Many of us here tonight are still grieving the loss of a friend or a loved one. Over time, we learn how to be in the world without someone who was important to us. Over time, we form new habits and new connections to the world at large. We learn to imagine a future where the impact of our loss is diminished, but never truly forgotten. We hope that this evening allows you to connect with others, to rebuild a new set of relationships while still remembering those special people in our lives. If you have questions about hospice, please reach me after the ceremony or look for somebody else wearing one of these lanyards. There's some special recognitions I'd like to make tonight. Our sustaining light partner is Rudney Associates. We want to thank Sandra Venato, Mayor Tim Flaherty, Paul and Sheila Petruvo, Supervisor Ken Carlson, the City of Pleasant Hill, the Pleasant Hill Recreation and Park District, the Pleasant Hill Police Department, and Slow Hand Barbecue Pleasant Hill. And if you'll notice on the back of your programs, there's a special offer from Slow Hand Barbecue tonight. If you take this program with you, you can receive, they'll donate 20% of your bill to Hospice East Bay. So keep that in mind after tonight's ceremony. With this, I'm going to turn things over to Sarah Benoit. Sandra.
Good evening, everyone. I was a little worried that it wouldn't be dark enough this evening to really have this Tree of Lights be as impressive as it is, but I was wrong about that. What is impressive is the number of you that have come out this evening to participate in this event. It's such a very important emotional event for everybody. On behalf of my board of directors and the staff of Pleasant Hill Recreation Park District, we're delighted to be part of this very special ceremony this evening. I know in my family, we're multicultural and we celebrate Dia de los Muertos. It is an event where you put pictures and remembrances of people who've gone before in a very special place, and you think about them and you say their name. And in part, it is such a deeply cultural thing to be able to say someone's name and to keep them memorialized in that way. So we are just absolutely thrilled and pleased to be able to know that the Hospice of East Bay has selected this location, this tree, for our community, amongst all the other sorts of communities that you are doing similar ceremonies for, but we're very pleased and Pleasant Hill to have you here this evening. So thank you to you, Bill, to your staff, everything that you do for all of us. And with that, I would like to introduce the mayor of Pleasant Hill, Tim Flaherty. Tim?
Good evening and welcome to Pleasant Hill. On behalf of the city, I want to introduce some of my council members who are here with us tonight. We have Councilmember Sue Nowak, Councilmember Matt Rinn, and Councilmember Zach Chess. On their, our collective behalf, welcome. We gather to remember and celebrate the lives of beloved family and friends. When lit, each light on the tree behind me will represent someone dear to us and allow us to find comfort in the presence of each other and our compassionate community. Thank you all for being here tonight and for your support of Hospice of East Bay. Many of us have been touched by hospice. For me, hospice first came into my life more than a decade ago to help my family in my father's last months and days following a terminal cancer diagnosis. With the assistance of the dedicated team at hospice, the staff and volunteers, my dad was able to die at home with dignity, comfort, and peace surrounded by his family. In his last days, my three brothers and my three sisters and our mom gathered at the family home to honor his beautiful life. Hospice guided me and the family through this emotional journey that spanned several months. We again relied on hospice when my mother received a terminal cancer diagnosis and a prognosis, like my dad's, that we had many months to prepare. But our remaining time together was incredibly brief. The morning we were told of my mom's diagnosis, she was released from the hospital and returned home. The EMTs that drove her home turned out to be children of a mother that my mother had grown up with. And that brought her tremendous joy and laughter on the ride home from the hospital. Hospice had already delivered a hospital bed, and we were scheduled for our intake appointment that afternoon at 3 p.m. with the hospice nurse. My mom conversed with the EMTs until they left, and then she and I sat next to each other in her sitting room going through her mail that had come while she was in the hospital. She got settled in a recliner and she was very talkative. And then something changed, just like that. Suddenly her outgoing became introspective. Her comfort became discomfort. She needed to lie down. We put her in the hospital bed that hospice had just delivered that morning, and she promptly fell asleep. When the hospice nurse arrived at 3 p.m., she examined my mom and advised us that she was in the final stages of her life, and that if we wanted to say goodbye to her, we needed to all gather immediately. So the siren was sent to the family, with all the brothers and sisters, the grandkids, cousins, all came over to the house that evening to hold vigil for my mom. The nurse accelerated the delivery that day of the medication and supplies that we didn't think we were gonna need for many months to come. We were shocked and disbelieving, but grateful for the calming presence of the hospice nurse, which kept us together and made it possible for all of us to gather and be with her when my mom took her final breath later that night. We were blessed to have this assistance from hospice, and we're blessed to have this not-for-profit Hospice East Bay right here in Contra Costa to support us at our most difficult moments. So let the light of this tree behind us warm your heart and remind you of your loved ones and the important services Hospice East Bay provides to families who are in need of compassionate care. And tonight, let us also pledge to be a source of light and comfort for those in need here in Pleasant Hill and around the world. Thank you.
Keep me in your heart for a while. If I leave you, it doesn't mean I love you any less. Keep me in your heart for a while. When you get up in that morning and you see that crazy sun, keep me in your heart for a while. There's a train leaving nightly when all is said and done. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sometimes when you're doing simple things around the house, maybe you'll think of me and smile. You know I'm tied to you like the buttons on your blouse. Keep me in your heart for a while. Hold me in your thoughts. Take me to your dreams. Touch me as I fall into view. When the winter comes, keep the fires lit. I'll be right there with you. Engine driver's head and North Pleasant Stream. Keep me in your heart for a while. These wheels keep on turning, but they're running out of steam. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. My name is Emma Barron. I'm Vice President of Quality Education and Compliance with Hospice East Bay. It is my honor to be here with you tonight, and I am reciting a poem called Shipwreck. As for grief, you'll find it comes in waves. When the ship is first wrecked, you're drowning, with wreckage all around you. Everything floating around you reminds you of the beauty and the magnificence of the ship that was and is no more. And all you can do is float. You find some piece of the wreckage and you hang on for a while. Maybe it's some physical thing, maybe it's a happy memory or a photograph. Maybe it's a person who is also floating. For a while, all you can do is float. Stay alive. In the beginning, the waves are 100 feet tall and crash over you without mercy. They come 10 seconds apart and don't even give you time to catch your breath. All you can do is hang on and float. After a while, maybe weeks, maybe months, you'll find the waves are still 100 feet tall, but they come further apart. When they come, they still crash all over you and wipe you out. But in between, you can breathe, you can function. You never know what's going to trigger the grief. It might be a song, a picture, a street intersection, a cup of coffee. It can be just about anything, and the waves come crashing. But in between, there is life. Somewhere down the line, and it's different for everybody, you find that the waves are only 80 feet tall or 50 feet tall. And while they still come, they come further apart. You can see them coming. An anniversary, a birthday, or Christmas, or landing at O'Hare. You can see it coming for the most part and prepare yourself. And when it washes over you, you know that somehow you will, again, come out the other side, soaking wet, sputtering, still hanging on to some tiny piece of the wreckage, but you'll come out. The waves never stop coming, and somehow you really don't want them to, but you learn that you'll survive them. And other waves will come, and you'll survive them too. Thank you. And now I'd like to introduce, I'm sorry, I don't have it in front of me. Oh, now I'd like to introduce Ken Carlson, District 4 Supervisor, Contra Costa County, who will be reading the names.
Good evening. I'm Ken Carlson, and I'm privileged to read the names of those that we remember, celebrate, and honor tonight. I'll apologize ahead of time, just in case I mess it up a little bit. Mary Jane Ocklam, Gary Barron, Terry Brower, Jacob Lee Brooks, Justin Brooks, Joey Carini, Stephanie Joanne Kayer, Mary Chatfield, Mary Phil Compton, Gladys May Cook, Linda Sue Poor, Bob Coratone, Mario Catrugo, Anne Marie Catrugo, Phyllis Catrugo, William Doherty, Don Fairclough, Lolly Fairclough, Jeremy Ficken, Paul Thiel, John Ward Flaherty, Don Fitzsimmons, Lucia Rose Flaherty, Paul Gutman, Kenneth Harold, Mary Hartvigson, Nancy Haupt, Tom Haupt, Betty Hirsch, Joseph P. Eiten, Margaret Jensen, Lawrence Jensen, Shirley Keel, Richard Kopek, Oksun Kopek, Karen Kopek, Kimberly Kopek Gordon, Gretchen Krylau, Arlene Kula, Gary Madsen, Law Masoni, Michael Mimiaga, Robert Mimiaga, Russ Morrison, Henry Munoz Jr., Bill Music Sr., Sid Massiter, Martin Fitzgerald Nealis, Terry Nelson, Edward Nelson, Barbara J. New, John Nolan, Michael Nolan, Patrick J. Norris, Ed and Lucille Quinn, Batul Ratmakala, Lucille Ritchie, Andy Ritchie, Gerald Silva, Albert Simonetti, Grace Strand, Melvin Strand, Melvin Strand Jr., Ralph Turgeson, Ann Turgeson, Donald Thau, Willis C. Thoit, Margaret Ann Valdez, Robert Randolph Walker, Michael James Christopher Williams, Maxine Wilson, Nancy F. Wilson, Donald F. Wilson. Our lights.
It's my great pleasure to present the Pleasant Hill Tree of Life.